So next, so coming to the another method, that is we have the volume method in the class box. So we have two methods. One is box method and another one is volume method. So out of these two methods, box method is called as constructor. Okay. So then coming to the next class, which contains the main method. Okay. If you look at this example, box demo 7. Okay. This contains the main method. Okay. Is the screen visible properly for all of you?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So box demo 7, this is the class name in which it contains main method. So this, for this program, we have to save this program by the name boxdemo7.java because it contains main method. Okay. So next, it contains two objects, mybox1 and mybox2. Okay. So here, see, by using box constructor, we have initialized. So that is, listen here, this value 10 will be copied to W. Value 20 is copied to H. Value 15 is copied to D. So that I can show you in this diagrams part where I have done here. Okay, if you look at this diagram, so here font size is okay. Is it visible properly, this image file?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so look here, left side.
Yes, sir.
Okay, my box one equals to new box of 10, 20, 15. So if you look at the arrow marks, what I have put, so 10 is copied to W, 20 is copied to H, 15 is copied to D. See here, so 10, 20 and 15 are integers, but in the constructor we have the variables of type double. Okay, so automatically it will convert from integer to double. So one more thing you have to remember in case of type conversion, that is converting from one data type to another. So if you are converting from integer to float or integer to double, it will convert easily. There will be no problem because integer will be having less amount of memory than the float and double. So this is very important. Integer will be having less amount of memory. That is, int will be having 2 bytes or 4 bytes, but whereas float and double will be having 8 bytes. So it will automatically copy. So we need not worry about any memory. Okay. So 10 is copied to W, 20 is copied to H, and 15 is copied to D. Then again, this W, that is, it is copied to width, and H is copied to height, D is copied to depth. So if you look at the assignment statements, width equal to W, height equal to H, depth equal to D. So from RHS variable, it will copy to the LHS variable. So W is copied to width, H is copied to height, D is copied to depth. So if you look at the memory representation of my box one object, so it's very clear. So width, the data member width will be having the value 10. The data member height will be having the value 20. The data member depth will be having the value 15. Okay. So this is about my box one. Okay. Now coming to the right side, so right side of the image file. So my similarly, box my box 2 equals to new box of 3, 6, 9. Okay, so 3 is copied to W, 6 is copied to H, 9 is copied to D. So it works similar. So in case of my box 1, how it is copied? Same way in case of my box 2 also it is copied. Okay, again that W, H and D values are copied to width, height and depth values respectively. So my box 2 values are 3, 6 and 9. So my box 2 of width is 3. My box 2 of height is 6. My box 2 of depth is 9. See, one important point here you have to remember is we can create many number of objects, n number of objects. So each object will get its own copy of data members. So this is very important point. Each object will get its own copy of data members. That is, see, once you store the values 10, 20 and 15, and again, if you store the values 3, 6 and 9, this 3, 6 and 9 will not replace 10, 20 and 15. It will copy separately in the computer memory. So if we want to access mybox 1, if we access mybox 1 values, we will get 10, 20 and 15. If we access mybox 2 values, we will get 3, 6 and 9. Okay. Then coming to the calculation of volume, you look at the left side of the image. Volume equal to mybox 1 dot volume. So you observe this object. So which object I have used? So I have used mybox 1 dot volume. So this volume function is present inside the program, that is inside the class box. If you look at this screen, so double volume okay, width into height into depth. See here I have written width into height into depth. You look at the variables width, height and depth. Before width or before height or before depth, I didn't use the object like my box 1 dot width or my box 1 dot width height or my box 1 dot depth. It is understood it will take its respective object. That is, if you look at this line, volume is equals to my box 1 dot volume. So here it will take my box 1's value. So if you look at the image file, so if you are calling volume equals to my box 1 dot volume, it will take 10, 20 and 15. It will not take 3, 6 and 9. You look at the right hand right side of the image. If you look at volume equals to my box 2 dot volume, it will take 3, 6 and 9. So it will not take 10, 20 and 15. It will take the values 3, 6 and 9 because it refers to the my box 2 object. So it will calculate volume like this: 10 into 20 into 15 for my box 1, 3 into 6 into 9 for my box 2. So if you look at the output, so here volume is 3000, that is for my box 1, and volume is 162.0, that is for my box 2. Okay, so you can copy the output as well as this tracing you copy. So from this image file, you copy the tracing, you write these things as well as arrow marks. So when you read on your own programs, you will understand easily. So while copying tracing, if you have questions, you can ask.
So Raj.
Finished?
Yeah. No, sir. Completed, sir.
Okay, next topic we will copy the output also.
Yes, sir.
Okay, I think it is set previous programs.
Sir?
In previous programs also same output we got. Only thing is in different way programs are written, that's all. Okay. So okay. Copy the output. Volume is 3000.0. Next volume is 162.0. Okay. Next topic you take down, method overloading. Method overloading. Okay, look at the screen. Method overloading is one of the ways of polymorphism. The process of having two or more methods within the same class that with different parameter declarations is known as method overloading. When Java encounters a call to an overloaded method, simply executes method whose parameters match the arguments in the call. So for this, if we take simple example, here. So in case of C++ also the method overloading concept is there, that is function overloading. So function overloading means having many functions with the same name but with a different parameter list. See, for example, if I take int sum, okay, so this is one function. And another function with the same name, but you take one, at least one parameter here. Okay, another function with the same name, take two parameters. You take another function with only one parameter but different data type. Okay. So look here. So I have taken the functions, four functions with the same name sum, but here if you look at the first function, there is no parameter. Okay, if you look at the second function, there is one parameter with data type int, and if you look at the third function, there are two parameters with int, and if you look at the fourth function, there is only one parameter. So second function and fourth function look similar, but the data type is different. So in the second function, data type is int. In the last function, data type is float. So in that way also, it can differ. So you should not worry about the return type here. It can be anything. It is same also, not a problem. Okay. The main concept in function overloading is having same name but with different parameter list. Or if the parameter lists are same, same number, data type should be different at least. Okay. So if you look at this concept. This is called method overloading. So when it comes to Java, they are telling the process of having two or more methods within the same class, because in Java we are writing all the code in the class itself. So every code in Java will be written in a class. So they are telling within the class itself that share the same name, but with different parameter declarations is known as method overloading. See, this is one of the type of polymorphism. So polymorphism means, the meaning of poly is many. The polymorphism means one thing which behaves in different way in different situations. Okay, that is, see, look at these functions. See, even though the function name is same, we'll change the function name so that you will understand. If I say ABC, okay. Alien. So look here. So if I take these four functions with the same name area, but inside this function name, if you write the different code, so then we can call that as a polymorphism. See, polymorphism concept is, even though we have same function names, but inside that, if you write the different code, that is called polymorphism. So in polymorphism, function overloading and operator overloading, two things will come. But here we will see function overloading, that is method overloading. Okay. You just copy these things. So about method overloading, later we will see the program. Finish writing.
Yes, sir.
So we'll go for the program. So I'll explain first. Okay, look at this program which demonstrates method overloading. See, as the definition says, having more methods within one class with the same name. Okay, see, if you look at this class overload demo, in this class we have the function name test. So that test function is defined many times. Look here. So this is one test function and test of int a. And another one, test of int a comma int b, and again double test of double a. So function name is for four. The name is look at the parameters list. Okay, you look at the first test function. There are no parameters at all. So we can write the methods without parameters also. Okay, the parameters are not compulsory. Okay, and next thing, this we have written the test function, but with one parameter. Only one parameter, that is the data type is int. And next test function we have written with two parameters, okay, int a and int b. And next test function we have written with one parameter, but the data type is different, double. If you look at this function, that is void test int a, and the last test function double test of double a, only one parameter is there in both the cases, but the data type is different. Okay, if you make the data type different, then we can say that is the method overloading concept. Okay, now coming to the next class, which contains the main method. Okay, if you look at the main method, so we will see how it works. Okay, so overload demo ob equals to new overload demo. Okay, so if we want to call a method which is present inside the class like test function, so we have to create an object and then we have to call that method. So we have created an object called as ob. Okay, then using that object ob, we have called the function, that is ob dot test, next ob dot test of 10, next ob dot test of 10 comma 20, then result is equals to ob dot test of 123.5. okay, so then we are printing the value. So when we call ob dot test, okay, that method, so the control will pass to the function where there are no parameters, that is this function, first function, void test, that is system.out.println, no parameters. For this function, control will be passed. Okay, next, when we call ob.test of 10, okay, so you look at the parameter, that is 10, and that type is integer. If you look at this argument value 10, the type is integer, so it will call the method void test of int a. Okay, this function. Okay, so then next function is ob dot test of 10 comma 20. So we have two values, that is 10 and 20, both are of type integer, so it will call the function void test of int a int b. This function it will call, so where it will print a and b. Okay, then last one, ob dot test of 123.25. if you look at this function, so it has the argument and that data type is double, or we can consider floating point value. So that will call this function, that is the last function, double test of double a. So understood. So here ob dot test will call the method where there is no parameter. Ob dot test of 10 will call the method where there is integer type parameter. Ob dot test of 10 comma 20 will call the method where there are two parameters which are of type integers. Ob dot test of 123.25 will call the method where there is a double data type. So if you look at this explanation in the paragraph, when Java encounters a call to an overloaded method, it simply executes the method whose parameters match the arguments in the call. Okay, it will check for two things, number of arguments and as well as data type of the arguments. Okay, number of arguments and the data type of the arguments, then it will call that particular method. So you copy this program. So tracing part I will show you in the diagram, I will show you. So copy this program.
Sir, scroll moderation. Sir.
We'll copy the output also, everybody.